So for today class, I will start with chapter 1, which is alcohol. So upon completion of this topic, student will be able to draw and give the IUPAC name of the structure which involve alcohol, identify the alcohol class and define the basicity, acidity and physical properties of alcohol, and explain the reaction and method preparation of alcohol and write the reaction and method preparation of alcohol. For today, I will focusing on the topic learning outcome for number one only, draw and give the IUPAC name of the structure which involve alcohol. So basically, I will focus this part for today, which are IUPAC names, structure, and the functionality of the hydroxyl group. So basically, what is the general formula for the OH? So the alcohol, it contain the OH group. The functional group of an alcohol is an OH group bonded to an sp3 hybridized carbon. And the bond angle about the hydroxyl oxygen atom are approximately 109.5 degree. So oxygen is also sp3 hybridized, and the two sp3 hybrid orbitals form a sigma bond to a carbon. So sigma bonds is representing the single bond, and single bond between the carbon and hydrogen. The remaining two sp3 hybrid orbitals is contain an unshared pair of electron. Okay, we can divide into two type of naming, common name and IUPAC naming. Normally the standard one is IUPAC naming. The IUPAC naming, how to do the IUPAC naming? The parent chain is the longest chain that contains the OH group. And then you need to number the parent chain in the direction that give the OH group the lowest number. And then you need to change the suffix E to all. For example, you have butane, then you need to change to butanol. And for the common name, so it is derived by naming the alkyl group attached to the alcohol when adding the word alcohol. Okay, normally when you have four carbon, so it representing butane. So if you want to do the common name, so butane will change to butyl. Butyl are alcohol. Okay, let's take a look of this example here. So here you have two carbon. So the common name in the bracket is ethyl alcohol, and the IUPAC name is ethanol. You need to put the suffix OL here. Same goes to 1-propanol. So here, why you need to put 1? Because the location of the OH is at carbon number 1. So you put 1-propanol, or the common name is propyl alcohol. And here, the location of the OH group is at carbon number 2. So you put here 2. So I would like to refresh back the way to write the IUPAC name. Okay, in between number and alphabet, you need to put dash. In between number and number, you need to put comma. Okay, here you have 1, 2, 3, 4. So you need to put 1-butanol, because here the OH group attached to carbon number 1. And here is OH group attached to carbon number 2. So you put 2-butanol or sert-butyl. Okay, then I will refresh back what you already learned in organic 1. So what is SEC? SEC stand for secondary. Secondary butyl, or the abbreviation for the second is SEC. So when you put SEC butyl, means that secondary butyl. is referring to the OH group that attached to the carbon that is we call as the secondary carbon. Okay, why here you categorize this carbon is secondary carbon? Because this carbon attached to one carbon at the right side and another one carbon at the left side. So we can conclude here this carbon is representing secondary carbon. And then here is 2 methyl 1 propanol. So here we observe 1 substituent, which is alkyl group. So do not forget to put the location of the substituent, which is 2. And then here, why we put third? Third is the abbreviation for tertiary. Okay, as you can see here, then the carbon is attached to 1, 2, 3. So this carbon is representing tertiary carbon. So here you put third butyl alcohol. This is the common name for this structure. And the IUPAC name is 2-methyl-2-propanol. Normally in the final assessment or in the quiz or in the test or in the lab report, normally we will use IUPAC naming rather than common name. And then here is the structure of the alcohol that attached to the cyclic ring. So you need to put cyclohexane, and the name you will change, the suffix you will change to OL. So it will be cyclohexanol. So for today exercise, I want you to do this question in the class notebook, in the folder tutorial and homework. So please do this question A, B and C. So for IUPAC naming only. Okay, then you need to see the compound containing 2 OH group are named is diol, 3 OH group are named as triol. Okay, when we observe 2 OH group in the parent chain, so you need to put di. And then 1, 2 is the location of the OH group. Okay, if observe 1, 2, 3 OH group, so you need to put tri. So 1, 2, 3 is the location of the alcohol. Then we continue with the unsaturated alcohol. So when we talk about unsaturated, okay, what do you remember? The information that you already learned in the organic chemistry 1. So what does it mean by unsaturated? So when we talk about unsaturated, means that the carbon is consists of double bond or triple bond or benzene ring. So in this case, it is referring to double bond. Okay, the double bond is shown by the infix. The hydroxyl group is shown by the suffix. The number the change to give OH the lowest number. Okay, for example here, first step, you need to determine the longest parent chain. Means that you need to find the longest carbon chain. So here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So representing hexane. So for alkane, but here is OH and double bond. So here you need to put if you observe 2 functional group in the parent chain, for example here is alcohol and double bond. So please put alcohol as your priority. Means that the location of the OH at the lowest number. So here you put number 1. And the double bond is location number 3. So it will be trans 3-hexenol, hexene 1-ol. Okay, what is E? E is representing the configuration of trans. Configuration of trans means that here is down, from up and down, one H above, this H at the up and down. So normally you just write like this and it is correct, trans. Okay, later please continue your homework with question A until H. Okay, that's all for today. So later on Thursday, before Thursday, I will discuss about the answer, and then before that I will see, is it you do your homework and complete it in the class notebook or not before Thursday. Okay, thank you.